Okay, in this video I'm going to continue on with exercise 1B. The question I'm going to do is number 16 and it's on page 18 of the book Fundamental Applied Mathematics. In this question you're given that a vector v has a magnitude of 2. Remember, the straight angle brackets mean a magnitude, and it's given a direction of west 40 degrees north. So first of all, just a quick recap on your compass, NSEW. Okay, so west is as you look there to the left. What we're asked basically is to find out the value of its component unit vectors. Once again, we'll have heard this in the past, but I'll explain it again as we go along. The first thing to do, of course, is to sketch the vector v. So we draw our x-axis and we draw our y-axis. Together these make our Cartesian plane, or our xy plane. Quickly I'm going to define my unit vectors, i-hat like that, and j-hat like that. Remember, this hasn't changed. And this will never change. And just because I want to have plenty of room, I'm going to get rid of that. Keep it on your copy though. So the first thing we do is we look at the direction. What does that mean? It means 40 degrees north of west. So go west and then go 40 degrees to the north. So this way is west. So 40 degrees north of west might look something like this. This would be 40, like that. Of course, the angle up here where my dot is now would be the 50 degrees. Like so, that's the vector v, and we know the magnitude of the vector is 2. So that would be the hypotenuse of the vector, of the triangle made by the vector. Next thing is we're asked to find its component unit vectors. Now, just a very quick recap, I know this, we've seen this plenty of times, but say if I have a vector a like that, a vector b like that, and a vector c like this. If I want to find out a plus b plus c, I draw the first vector, I draw the tail of the second vector and the head of the first, like this, and I draw, actually I'll change that direction to maybe this, and I draw the tail of the third vector and the head of the first vector, or the second vector, like that. I'm just going to make it nice and long just so it just makes things easier. And you draw your resultant vector from the tail of the first to the head of the last vector, like this. It obviously doesn't need to be dotted, I'm just doing that for clarity. So this vector here is A, this one is C, and the one in the middle is B. So the dotted line vector would be A plus B plus C. So that vector, A plus B plus C, is the resultant vector from adding the three component vectors, A plus B plus C. Similarly, the vector v, which we have above, is also a resultant vector made up of two component vectors, one in the i-hat direction, or the x-axis, and one in the j-hat direction, or the y-axis. So we're just asked to find those out. And this boils down to simple trigonometry. So there's the first vector like that, there's the second vector. So we know that Sakatoa exists as follows. Now, we're going to go that sine 40 is equal to the opposite over the hypotenuse, which is of value 2. Therefore, the opposite is equal to 2 sine 40. Similarly, and I'll just draw this up down here like this. Similarly, if you do the exact same thing, you'll see that the adjacent is equal to 2 cos 40, like that. So I'm just going to draw those directly onto my diagram. Pause the video if that was a bit quick. So this vector here in the i-hat direction, a negative i-hat direction, is 2 times the cosine of 40, because it is the adjacent side, and this one is 2 sine of 40 because it is the opposite side. That means the vector v, its magnitude is 2 units. The vector v is made up of two component vectors. Now, look at our, if we draw our Cartesian plane quickly like this, we know that because of the direction of the arrows, plus I hat plus j hat, negative I hat plus j hat, negative negative, plus I hat negative j hat, like so. And we're in the second quadrant up here, therefore we should have negative I hat, positive j hat. So, we know the magnitude of the i-hat is 2 cos 40. We know its direction is negative, so it's minus 2 cos 40 I hat, and we know it's plus 2 sine 40 j hat, like that. So therefore the vector v is equal to what? We plug it into our calculator and we say 2 cos 40 is minus 1.53 I hat plus 2 sine 40, giving me 1.28 j hat. 1.28 j hat. Now just let me have a look at this and check in the back of the book. So we're doing 1b question 16. And that's exactly what it has in the back of the book. So that's how you do that. So please subscribe to my channel. I hope you enjoyed watching. Thanks for watching, and pass this video on to your friends.